Hello everyone, welcome to Angular 1 and Angular 2 performance demo. So as you can see from the screen that we are something doing with the performance to compare the performance of Angular 1 and Angular 2. And I wanted to just to focus on that there has been a lot of talk about Angular 1 is being slow to manipulate the DOM. So now we were curious about that to check how slow is it compared to the new version of Angular, which is Angular 2 right now, which is in beta mode. So the problem is here is that we wanted to push all Angular all the code of this Angular 1 and Angular 2 to its limits, like to push them to limits to manipulate the DOM with a lot of complex calculations going on behind them. So what is your approach to take this problem, to solve this problem? So our approach is to create a directive and get inside the directive and repeat that. We are using nested repeats to approach to push Angular 1 and Angular 2 to its limits. So right now I'll what is the setup? I will explain what is the current setup of what you can see on the screen. So first of all, here Angular 1 is app is running on port number 9090, and on the second window Angular 2 app is running on port number 8080. So I wanted to just explain that both these apps are written in the same logic. Even if their components and behind the structure is different, the logic to implement the feature is same. So there is no question that there is some difference in the and biasing is going on. So next we'll load the matrix which we have created. So so just a little bit about the matrix and how we are implementing this approach to solve the problem is that we are taking 31 days and 24 hours, and we are creating a matrix of 31 into 24 to create a cell of around 744 cells in that 24 into 31 matrix, and we will try to randomly generate those 744 cells by using Angular change detection modules. And here we have to focus on that Angular change detection in Angular 1 is different and Angular 2 has been implemented different. So Angular change detection can also be said as the DOM manipulation, how Angular 1 and Angular 2 manipulates DOM and change the values on the DOM. And we can also say that how it binds the value of value which is changing, and we know that it does two-way binding kind of thing. So now starting with the load button on Angular 1, and I'll try to keep as concurrent both of this running. So let's start with Angular 1 load, and then on Angular 2 load. You can see little bit is difference is there, but the main difference you will see in the coming manipulating all those 744 values of this matrix. So let's start with that. So first Angular 1, I'll click the search whole month. And so yeah, just to explain what it will do after clicking on search whole month on Angular 1 and Angular 2. So we are taking this 24 into 31 matrix, and if you can see every cell is clickable, and we are changing the every cell's value randomly based on time of function, and we are generating that number from random class. So let's start with that. So I'll go with first Angular 1, there it is, and Angular 2. You can see the difference between Angular 1 DOM manipulation and Angular 2 DOM manipulation. Angular 2 is almost finished and Angular 1 is still going on, and it is way behind Angular 2's DOM manipulation thing. So it is obvious from the video and what you saw on the web app that Angular 1 is way behind of Angular 2 in DOM manipulations performance. So So the question comes in, and you might be curious that why it is Angular 2 is way faster than Angular 1. So the solution is here. The way change detection is approached in or implemented in Angular 1 is that kind of if one value, one cell is getting changed somehow, then it will take all the cells and it will try to update the and check the that they are also changed or not. It kind of does a repetitive checking on all those 744 cells. Let's take a case of that we have changed one cell value, and next it comes there are left 743 cells. So what it will do is it will check that if 743 other cells are also changed or not. So it will bind those value also, and it will go with digest cycle. So that is why Angular 1 performance is very slow and it is too costly for the CPU. Next, explaining Angular 2 performance, what it does, it if one value has been changed, it keeps a cache kind of things that it remembers that other values have not been changed, and it only updates one value. So and that's why the digest cycle takes less time to implement and to change the DOM. So that's why Angular 2 is way fast. So that's what a simple demo of Angular 1 and Angular 2 DOM manipulation performance, and we'll explore a lot more things in Angular 1 and Angular 2, and we'll try to get insights about that. Thank you for watching video.